Hi everybody, this is Susan Elliott, author of Getting Past Your Breakup and Getting Back Out There, and today we're going to do relationship court. What is relationship court? Well, when I watch television and there's a therapist show on, and there's not a lot of female therapists on the air, which makes me crazy, or a judge show, it's like the therapist will always say, I'm not a lawyer, but, and the judge will say, I'm not a therapist, but, well, I have been a therapist for 20 years and I've been a lawyer for 12 years, so I'm going to talk about some relationship issues that intersect with some legal issues. So I'm not your lawyer and I'm not your therapist, so this is not therapeutic or legal advice, but it's legal information with some therapeutic advice thrown in and a little bit about the issues that seem to plague a lot of different people. We're going to be talking about gifts. We're going to be talking about leases. We're going to be talking about when to fish or cut bait, you know, when you're in a breaking up situation and there's some legal issues to deal with, whether or not you're married. We're going to deal about children. We're going to deal about a whole lot of things. So this is relationship court. Today we're going to talk about the universal problem of when to give the engagement ring back. I talk about this in Getting Past Your Breakup. An engagement ring differs from other gifts in that it's a conditional gift. It's a gift given in contemplation of marriage, meaning that if you don't go through with the marriage, the gift goes back to the sender. That's very cut and dry. And in most jurisdictions around the country, and we're talking the United States, I don't know what it is in other countries, this will be the law. Now, if you're in a relationship with somebody and you're the woman and the guy gives you an engagement ring, and I'm using that as an example because that is the most likely scenario, and whoever breaks off the engagement, it doesn't matter. I've seen women say to me, I didn't break off the engagement. He broke off the engagement. How does he get the ring back? He gets the ring back because it's a gift given in contemplation of marriage. It's his ring when the condition, I'm going to marry you, doesn't happen. It doesn't matter whose fault it is, who called off the wedding. It doesn't matter. It goes back to the person that bought it. Now, in most cases, and I hope this is the case, the guy buys the ring, gives it to the woman. If you're a woman who bought your own engagement ring, you've got bigger problems than this engagement ring. I don't believe that anybody should buy their own engagement ring. The only exception to that is I had a client who had been engaged once before. When the fiance left, he said, keep the ring. I don't want it. I don't care. And he was gone for years. She met this other guy. She had the ring in a drawer. Of course, she's not going to wear an engagement ring. And they moved in together. He supported her for about a year and a half, and then they decided to get married. And so she wanted to sell the engagement ring and put it toward the new one. That's perfectly fine. The guy was supporting her. She wasn't doing anything with the other ring. You know, she could have sold that ring and bought anything she wanted to, but she wanted a bigger engagement ring than he could afford. He had been supporting her. That's perfectly fine. That's a very reasonable situation. And that's one of the things that people have to understand when they're breaking up relationships. The law goes by the reasonable person standard. What would a reasonable person do? That's always the question. And I can tell you that a reasonable person under the law, they don't really care who bought the engagement ring. As a therapist, I care who bought the engagement ring. If you were coming to me with this situation as a therapist, I would say, what do you want to lose a guy who can't even afford to give you an engagement ring? Or if you're both so poor that you can't afford an engagement ring without taking credit in a jewelry store, what makes you think you should be getting married now? It's like that's not, you know, the ultimate situation. That's not the ultimate concern, the engagement ring. It's how financially stable are you to be getting married? I think that if the two of you are in such a bind that he can't afford to give you an engagement ring because he either has no money or no credit and you have to take credit out, you might want to rethink this whole wedding thing. Money is one of the biggest problems that married couples have. Why do you want to go into a marriage with money problems? You can have money problems when you get together. And that happened with my husband and I. We got together. We both had money in the bank. We were doing well. And then a series of events over the years really hit us hard. And we were struggling for a few years. And, you know, it was something that was completely unforeseen. So, and, you know, we were together, we had a healthy marriage, we had a good relationship, we got through it. But if you're having money problems before marriage, you're going to have money problems after marriage. So the bottom line is, if the person who gave you the engagement ring broke off the wedding, or you broke off the wedding, it goes back to the person who paid for the engagement ring. That's it, period, end of story. If you put it on credit, then keep it. But you have to decide whether or not you're going to pay for it. No court is really going to make him pay for the ring unless you're willing to give it back to him. And some courts will order you give him the ring and then he pays for it. But if he has no credit and no money, why do you think he's going to pay for it? It's like a lot of times they don't. And then you're going to have to sue him again in court. So don't be a fool. Don't pay for your own engagement ring. And if somebody bought you an engagement ring and the wedding's off, no matter who called it off, give it back. And no court is going to say, okay, you paid for X, Y, and Z, therefore you get to keep the ring. Engagement rings are very cut and dry. Don't think that you have any entitlement to it under any circumstances unless you pay for it. And if you pay for it, you've got bigger problems than that engagement ring. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay legal, and I'll see you next time in Relationship Court.